is, so I need to run to the bathroom.
Okay, and can you keep a lookout for Anna? She just disappeared on us.
A smiling Anna approached me. Why is the word walk in there? A smiling Anna approached me. That's a good sentence. That word walk kind of fucks it up. Psst, Anna. She recognized me, her smile faded.
What?
You should probably know that a worm is crawling around in your food.
What? A worm? How in the world would you know that?
I saw it there.
So you just left it? Why didn't you just toss the whole thing in the trash?
It's Anko's little prank or whatever. I'm just trying to warn you.
Fine. So that's how it's going to be. Time to kick some ass.
Hell yeah. Whoop their asses. Anna's aura has turned frightening. I definitely don't want to be on her bad side.
Anna, you finally came back. We've been waiting.
Time to eat, everyone!
Itadakimasu!
Eyes turned to the usually quiet Yukari, surprised by the lively shout. Itadakimasu! Anna stared suspiciously at her plate before picking up the chopsticks. Using the tip, she gently sorted through the rice, but found nothing. Anna frowned and glanced toward me suspiciously.
Are you hungry, Anna?
No, everything is fine. I think.
As everyone began eating, I decided I was too starved to be left behind and picked up a bowl to start enjoying the appetizing meal. Ah! They put it in mine. As the cold squirming worm slithered over my tongue, I spit all the food from my mouth and across the table. Anko and Haruka laughed hysterically.
We figured you went to warn Anna, so we decided to change victims. That was hilarious.
Is Anna enjoying this too? I was trying to help her. No, that was awful. Everyone continued to laugh, and eventually I couldn't help but join in. Guess I deserved a bit of pranking, and it really was totally unexpected. No, it was kind of expected. The moment Anna's like, there's nothing here, I'm like, ah, fuck, they put it in mine. We sat in Anka and Yukari's room, which wasn't very big, but offered a beautiful scene of the gardens with the window wide open. The mixture of four shampoo fragrances drove me crazy, but I kept focused. And the room was pretty chill, and the final game came to its logical conclusion.
Wait, how do you play this? Yukari, can you look and see if I have a good hand?
I can't look at them. We are opponents!
Oh, okay.
Haruka swayed from side to side and made perplexed grimaces. Maybe it helped her think, but it wasn't like her. Most likely, she played for the first time, even though she denied it. Anko didn't say a word throughout the whole game. She clearly wanted to win, and needed only one more good hand for her victory.
Haruka, can you stop moving, please? You're distracting me.
Anna, as usual, sported the perfect poker face, revealing nothing that would give away her position. Yukari was confused the entire game, simply too complicated for her to enjoy. But the cards in my hand show I'll be the winner in the final game, unless whether a miracle happens or... Okay, then you just... It is pretty much the final decision. Yeah. Alright, we'll play along with Haruka. She's playing like a naive child. Where's all her trick and cunning? Psst, Haruka. I whisper toward her.
What?
She keeps her focus intensely on her cards. Hey, you need to take this card from me.
I have my cards.
Oh god, take this card!
Okay...
What are you two talking about over there?
Keeping silent, I let Haruka take my card.
Okay. Now what?
Say I won.
Okay. I win!
Show it!
Here you go.
Haruka unfolded her cards to reveal her winning combo.
Now what?
End of the game. Congrats!
Yay! Give me a hug.
Jumping on Yukari, Haruka began to tickle her and laugh.
Hold on, I'm coming!
Gross! Anko jumped on both girls with a smile. It was something amazing, something I'd always imagined, like some beautiful moving painting. Surprisingly, Anna also glanced at them with a smile, but the moment she caught me watching, lifted her chin to remind me of her superiority. Someone pulled at my hand. Yes?
Let's go. I owe you a thank you.
Yes? Haruka led me toward the corridor with determination. Yes?
Finally, that stupid game is over. I was never very good at cards.
But you won. Isn't that cool? She smiled in silence, but it's obvious the cards don't interest her. Well, what's on your mind? I helped you win, so what do I get?
My undying gratitude. I don't know why you would take it so seriously, but I do appreciate your help. You're just the cutest thing.
Oh, you. Why do you think I helped you?
Honestly, I'm not sure.
Oh, we don't get a line for that one? Oh, there it is.
You're the first person who's cared so much. I've noticed it several times already, and it's surprising. I feel really good, but also confused, if that makes sense.
I get it. Yeah, I think I understand.
Well, I'd better go, but we'll talk again later.
Okay, be careful. Haruka can go from innocent and naive to sentimental very quickly. It explains a little more about her personality. Smiling at me, she walked out into the street. Then she got hit by a bus. It was very disturbing. After the game, we returned to our rooms. The chairs had left our backs numb while playing, so it was great to finally enjoy the relaxation of a bed. During the trip, I noticed something weird. I'd lost almost all interest in panties. I didn't have a wild desire to peek through or steal panties. It was a wonderfully strange metamorphosis, but I couldn't explain what had come over me. But why? Why suddenly was this happening? Earlier, I hadn't even bothered to try to know the girls. My focus was fixed on stealing their panties. And suddenly, at the onsen, we spoke and were sharing stories, laughing and learning and playing cards. In essence, we'd begun communicating on a personal level. It was like coming a... It was like coming a beautiful oasis of happiness in a desert of despair. I think you left out a key word or two there. It was like coming a beautiful oasis of happiness. Okay. Like I'd found a kind of Garden of Eden and was trusted to be its gardener. I still think panties are beautiful and intimate and seductive, that they will always be a special part of the girls, and... What the fuck? God damn it. These fucking subtitles are so shit sometimes. Be a part of the girls, and... But it does make... listen, I've played games with bad localizations before, but like, these... Ugh. And, but does it make sense to live this paradise of life and love and happiness for something so trivial? Beauty will save the world and me as well.
What the hell?
Hi. Oops, sounds like something is wrong in paradise. The door opened, all four girls rush into my room without so much as a hello. Anko approaches me boldly and grabs me by the collar before I could even stand from the bed. It's obvious she's angry, not playing around.
Have you decided to take revenge for your loss in the game?
What are you talking about?
You knew where our panties were, and there aren't any perverts around but you!
Uncle, we know he isn't guilty. Did you forget what happened at our house?
Did panties disappear at your house too?
Huh. What a coincidence.
This bastard was holding my panties and trying to get away with it!
Well, it's obvious he stole our panties.
Wait, how do you know it's me? Did you know Anna also likes pant- Anna steps up and punches me in the stomach.
But maybe it wasn't him. Who knows?
Anna, you're acting strange. Why didn't you let him finish talking?
Oh, he was just going to say something stupid. That I like pancakes.
Okay. Well,
and they're just like, yeah, okay, that makes sense.
Right now. Let's resolve this peacefully. I agree.
Me too. Show yourself, thief.
What are you thinking? Of course it's him. Who else do you expect?
The old man. Wait, I have an alibi.
How will you prove it?
Well, I'll need to think, and I'll need some time. You can call me guilty whenever you want, but I need to prove my innocence. Maybe it was one of you.
Or maybe it was that suspicious, filthy old man who runs the place.
My thoughts exactly.
He's been drunk and sleeping for a while now.
If no one wants to admit to theft, then I suggest we find our lost panties and appoint a chief investigator.
I agree with you, Kari. She has a point.
Fine. All right.
Also, I want to be the investigator.
Yeah, unless you've forgotten, sweetie. You're the main suspect. No can do. But maybe I'd be a good fit.
We remember your tricks. You're just as bad as he is when it comes to trust.
Oh, ouch.
I vote for you, Kari. She's the most responsible person here.
That is true.
I agree.
Me too. Yukari it is.
Yukari looked rather happy that she was trusted enough to be an investigator, and to have such a task, search out a thief with a hunger for women's panties.
Okay, I can do this.
Okay, then do it. Feels like we're in some kind of role-playing game right now.
Quiet, Mr. Suspect.
Oh, Jesus. Yukari giggled as the power trip went to her head.
Okay. Let's get out of here and find some clues.
It's frustrating to admit that I have no alibi. Needing to breathe, I walk along the corridors and get some water before returning to the room. Trying to prove myself innocent in this situation is going to be very problematic. None of the girls trust me, of course, so there's another issue. Who's guilty? If you ask me, I'd put my money on Haruka or Anko. Haruka likes pranks and Anko loves to alienate. Not like anyone's going to listen to me. But wait, maybe it was Anna. After all, she's also a Pantsu hunter. Could she also have an alibi that would keep them from suspecting her? While thinking, I accidentally lose track of my whereabouts and walk into one of the girls' rooms. As soon as I realize my mistake, I know I'm in trouble if anyone finds me. Turning to leave, I hear footsteps headed this way. Without a choice, I immediately dash for the closet and hide inside.
Are you sure you hid them well?
Yeah, no one will find them.
Oh, really?
Crap, she's headed right for me.
And what's that? Why are these pink panties sticking out right here? These are very cute and also stand out so anyone would notice.
Oh god. Oh, she's too obvious.
You got me into this, but you need to learn everything to keep your butt out of trouble. Do you understand?
With a sharp movement, Anna yanked the panties from the door gap. Thankfully, the door didn't even stir, and they didn't reveal me as they came free.
I know the better place to hide everything. Let me show you.
Awesome. Sounds perfect.
Okay, they're gone. Wow, those two are dangerous. But I won't be able to figure out this case without doing some investigating of my own. Should I follow them? I need to follow these criminals. They're headed outside. Will they hide the panties there? I quietly leave the building and hide behind a bush. They stand a small distance away as they talk between themselves. As they do, I notice Anna's hands are now empty. They must be stashing them out here somewhere.
Hold on. He's right there.
He followed us?
Shoot. They found me too soon. Hey, you two. Just came out here to have a seat. The air is really nice. Haruka walks over and puts a hand on my shoulder.
Come on. As if you were the one who stole panties. You're so cute, and your reactions are always so cute. I like you. But unfortunately, Yukari isn't so simple. She wants justice, and we couldn't frame you right away. And now you've found out everything. Now you're our partner in crime.
Okay. Then who do we frame?
Well, we don't have many options. There's only Anko left.
Why Anko?
Well, her reaction is particularly hilarious, explosive even, and she's cute in her own way, just like you.
Alright. Haruka winked and kissed my forehead, and Anna pretended she didn't care at all. As a result, Anko was blamed. She tried desperately to prove her innocence, but Yukari just looked at her sister disappointedly. In the very end, when enough lines had been crossed, Haruka admitted to everyone that the whole fiasco was just a joke, and she and Anna had stolen the panties as a ruse. Yet another unexpected crime duo. Okay, that's interesting.
Thank you for inviting me. I was very happy when I heard this from you. I haven't been able to get out anywhere for a long time. And then I got such an offer.
I know, right?
I have a feeling that you read me. That you know what I want. I like your insight. You're the first one who cares so much about me.
Go on. Oh yeah, me agreeing to blame Anko makes me a truly caring person. Haruka is quiet for a moment.
Usually, I manipulate people. But when I fall in love, I lose myself and let them manipulate me. My previous boyfriends took advantage and I felt so sick about it. You're the sweetest. I'll never forget this trip.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Go on. Despite the injustice, life remained beautiful, though, because I was in the circle of four nymphs, surrounded by which the beautifully starry sky appears like something truly unreal. Or maybe that's just flies before my eyes. I don't know, and I don't care. All I know is my mind is seeing the impossible and everything around me is stunning. I want to be here forever. This trip was absolutely the most amazing of my life, and I wonder if I'll ever see another that even begins to match. At least, while I was in the girls' closet, I was able to enjoy seeing all the girls' beautiful, sexy, and adorable panties at once. Haruka's ending. That's it. These endings are kinda lame. Well, time to retry it. Obviously, I'll cut out anything that's been shown before. There's no need in me fucking being like, oh, hey, yo, here's all this shit we've already seen before. I'll only do new shit. So now, I don't know. You know what? Now that I know which room is Yukari and Anko's, let's go for Anko's ending. So until there's new shit. Okay, so back in the hallway. This should be Anko and Yukari's room. Or at least that's what I would have heard and seen had I paid attention. Instead, I stared at the two beautiful girls before me.
You? What are you doing?
Awkward. Anko flushed crimson. But not at all of it seemed from anger. Still, I was pretty sure she was pissed enough to move mountains. Or snap my neck. Yukari, however, was completely embarrassed and covered herself with a large towel. She was so fast I didn't even get a chance to see anything. Just staring at the floor, she refused to look at me. Apparently, she couldn't stand the gaze of a prowler.
Why are you even in here?
Fantastic question. I was just stopping by to see if any of you ladies needed some help. I could help you change clothes by holding a mirror or something.
No! No one needs your help! Look at Yukari! She's so embarrassed!
I glanced at Yukari, but Anko interrupted me.
No! Stop looking at her!
You told me to look at her, but you just said—
Get out of here! Right now!
Okay! By the way, isn't Haruka supposed to be with you? Anko slammed the door in my face, making chills run down my back. Guess what we're going here? Thank God. Okay, so we've seen this shit. I'll skip ahead to when we've got more shit. Until then. Alright, and we're back at the moment where Haruka's like, hey, I'm not supposed to wear underwear. Well, now we're gonna have to agree with Anko. Be like, no, wear your underwear, goddammit. It was a little shame because I'd forgotten to wear boxers. Yeah, you'd forgotten. Of course you should wear them. It's just decent.
Well, I'm disappointed. I thought we shared a special bond.
We do, but I can't just admit it like that.
Yes, I agree. You should always wear panties.
Goddamn, look how excited she is. Like, yes! Underwear! Yes!
Well, except when you're in the shower, of course, but that's the only time.
That's the only time? What about when you're going to the bathroom? Do you keep your underwear on? What about when you're fucking? Should you keep your underwear on? Just saying. That's it. We're gonna come back to shit I've already seen. After a nice conversation, they went to the hot springs.
Oh,
and I run
sorry.
Into Haruka. Okay. So it looks like this shit I've seen before. Well, cut back to when new shit is happening.
Let me.
Okay, so I don't have to do this one, but I feel like it'd be more in line to do this one. We're at the choice for whether or not we warn Anna about the worm. And, you know, I feel like if we're going for Anko, we kind of maybe want to keep silent about it. Well, there goes nothing. Guess I'm also a bit interested in pulling Anna from her shell. It's difficult to get any emotion out of her. This should definitely work. Anna appeared in the doorway, but the room stayed silent, and in my mind, overly suspicious. She slipped into the open seat next to us. Everyone is here? Then let's eat.
Yeah. Itadakimasu.
Itadakimasu. Anna sat like a queen, her perfect posture reflecting a real aristocrat. She mentioned she didn't know how to use chopsticks, so they brought her a knife and fork instead. Sticking a fork in the rice, Anna brought the food to her lips as a worm slipped out and squirmed back and forth as it suffocated from lack of air.
How dare you?
Anko and Haruka started giggling, but Anna didn't appreciate this joke.
Thank you for dinner.
Standing, Anna grabbed an untouched apple and walked away. The smiles faded from their faces as their guilt ate at them.
I tried to warn you. Now look and see what happened over a stupid worm.
I mean, honestly, what the fuck did they expect?
I thought it would be fun.
Well, her reaction was funny. But now, what do we do?
Shouldn't we go and apologize?
Hey, Corey, you're her greatest friend. Can you apologize for all of us?
I think both of you should go. It was your idea, Anko.
I was just trying to make her laugh.
We should all go. Each of us is guilty for keeping quiet and not even warning her.
Not evening?
If you all want to be friends, we all need to act like it.
Exactly. You stuck with us, so you're an accomplice.
Fuck. Okay, let's go. We spent the next few minutes searching the entire onsen, but nobody saw her. We found Anna in the parking lot, searching for something in the back seat.
Anna!
She continued ignoring us.
Anna!
Nothing changed. Anna, the girls came to apologize. She stopped and glanced in my direction.
But you were with them. And you, Kari, too.
I know. And I'm really sorry, Anna.
I should never have agreed to this. Don't you like it here? I mean, the worm thing was really stupid. I see that now. But aren't you having any...
I see that now.
Yeah, I'm having a blast when I'm not with any of you.
Yikes. Kari fell to her knees in shame, clutching her hands over her chest.
I'm so sorry, Anna. Please forgive me. I didn't mean anything by it.
After her, Anko fell on her knees, and then Haruka.
Forgive us. We are all guilty. And we'll never do anything so stupid ever again.
After the girl spoke, Anna watched me with a cold, unemotional gaze. She didn't blink, didn't flinch, just waited until I finally fell to my knees and bowed before her. Please, Anna. I would be most grateful if you would forgive me, too.
When you're all in such a position, it's a lot easier to get along with all of you.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, okay. I forgive you all, but just don't hug.
Haruka jumped on Anna with a large hug. Yukari also went in for a hug. Even Anko didn't seem to mind. Ordinarily, Anna would have pushed them away, but it seems that, just for a moment, she could tolerate a few hugs from her friends. Can I?
No, you can't.
Afterward, we talked in the room before leaving to play a few games of cards, and each of us forgot to ask what Anna was looking for in the car. Probably like a fucking shotgun. Bitch was ready to snap. Oh shit, it's game time. Alright, let's just... This is only going to be a few seconds, so I'm just going to cut ahead. Then we'll play along with Anko. Should I help Anko? I doubt she'll like it, but I can try. It's just a silly card game. She wasn't taking the right card from me, so I had to outwit her and do some rearranging. Finally, she was able to take it, but didn't look the least bit happy. Anko has a bulge of anger on her forehead, but I know she'll be fine with it once she realizes I was just trying to help.
Yay. I won. And I'm out.
Anko? But wait, we haven't revealed our cards yet.
Look at her cards. Seems she found an early victory with your help.
Oh, strange. No, you imagined
well,
it.
Well, okay, if you say so.
This. Anna stretched herself gracefully and yawned. In response, I yawned automatically.
I'm gonna get something to drink, and I'll be in my room.
Okay, bye.
I'll go in the room, too. I'm a bit tired.
Okay, bye. Haruko remained to review the cards and rack her brain. I won't disturb her. Going out to take a refreshing walk, I met an angry Anko.
Why did you do that? I want to play a fair game!
Hey, just cool down. You almost lost this time. Before that, you lost twice. I could tell how frustrated you were since your cheeks were red and swollen. Just wanted to help you a little. Is it so wrong to be on your side? Stepping up quickly, she grabbed me by the collar.
Don't you understand? I don't need such victories. It's even worse than losing. And you're right. I hate losing. But is that such a bad thing?
Hey, it's just a card game. You should be able to lose and learn from it. Nothing will come from you getting pissed and pissed any yourself. Okay, it'll come in handy in the future. People don't look up to sore losers. You have to be ready to lose as much as you are to win. Still, I'm sure you'll win a lot in life, so you probably have nothing to worry about.
I know. I got it. You're right. Okay, thanks.
All right. Anko moved around the corner after giving me an interesting look. Hope she's not too angry at me. Maybe she'll relax after a while. Maybe. And then after the game, returned to our rooms. The chair is anything different, or does she come in here? One second. I'm gonna pause right here. If anything's different, I'll cut to it, but I doubt it. Okay, so now we're just after the moment after we were hiding in the closet after the whole panty theft investigation is going. We discovered that Anna and Haruka are sneaking panties. But instead of following them now, this is just too painful to watch. I didn't steal any of those panties, and I need to set everything straight with the investigator, if she'll even listen to me. On my way to find Yukari, I noticed my own door to my room. Open. I notice my own doors open to my room, and wonder if they're also trying to steal my underwear. Do they need that much? Entering the room, I find Anko rummaging through my bag. Shocked myself, I sneak up on her and grab her from behind. Hey, can I ask if you're going through my bag? Ooh, I get punched. Anko jumped up and knocked me over in the process.
Damn, don't scare me like that!
What? Decided to go looking for my boxers?
Of course not. I was looking for the panties you stole. I searched the entire room but didn't find anything. Maybe it wasn't you.
Yeah, no shit. It wasn't me. I've been with you and the girls. When would I have had the chance?
Not very funny. I remember what you did at our home.
I didn't steal anything. And actually, the girls did that.
Which girls?
Anna and Haruka. I overheard their conversation.
What? Well, is it true? Are you sure?
I accidentally walked into their room and they talked about where to hide them.
How did they do that? God, I was so sure it was you. I'm so sorry.
No, don't worry about apologizing. Help me find them so I can clear my name.
Yes! Time to punish these bitches for lying!
Yeah! Punishing bitches! After a bit of searching, we eventually found them and watched them hide the panties under a rotten bush on the street. Finding their panties would be unreal. What did they think? This wasn't funny. After Anna and Haruka left, we rescued the panties and brought them to Anna and Haruka and Haruka's room. After strewing them everywhere, Yukari caught us in the act. We explained everything, and she believed us. We didn't have to prove anything, because she completely trusted her sister's word, and maybe a little of mine. Anko and I hid in the closet and waited for the girls to return. Anko seems ready to burst with anticipation and joy, barely restraining her laugh.
It's strange, but I really have fun with this. With you and the girls. I don't remember when I had fun like this, except maybe some of Yukari's pranks. I could never find a way to talk to them, but it seems they don't always act so silly. These girls are not silly. I really am having a great time here. I feel like I'm ready to do things and make new accomplishments.
Hell yeah. While she spoke, I just listened, but it was true. Anko had changed. I'm really happy for you. Anko smiled sweetly and pushed me with her shoulder playfully. Finally, Anna and Haruka entered the room.
What in the world? But we hid all these!
Seems like someone must have followed us. Did you see anyone?
They were gonna burst out of the closet. Us, bitches!
No, but these panties have teddy bears on them. I think they're Anko's.
Anko hissed in laughter.
I think I have a feeling who might have been spying on us.
Anna approached the closet where we hid, but Anko jumped out in surprise.
Oh, boo! Gotcha!
There's a monster in here!
Haruka rushed out in panic as Anna stayed in place, narrowing her eyes at Anko while she clenched and unclenched her fists in anger.
I want to punch you so hard right now.
Then Anko threw her arms around Anna with a laugh.
Aw, I'm so sorry, but I couldn't resist. You had to be punished for being naughty.
Anko sneaked a look at me and gave me both a smile and a thumbs up. I smiled back and sighed in relief. At least our little tomboy was having fun. Is that it? Game over? Pretty much. Despite the injustice, yep. And it's the same shit. Okay. These endings seem so lackluster, honestly. It's like they have potential to be something, you know, good. Just even in a goofy way, I feel like they could be better, but whatever. Who do we got next? Yukari, let's do Yukari, I guess. Until I find new shit. Alright, so we're at the moment where we first arrive at the place, and Yukari is like, hey, you need some help, buddy? The last two times I said, nah, fuck off, but now we're gonna be like, hey, yeah, nah, I could use some help. Do you think you can manage it?
Well, I think it's far too difficult for you in your condition.
Oh, ouch. Well, here's the bag.
Well, it's a little heavy.
Yeah, suck it up. But I just gave her a small bag with some clothes. Are you sure you can handle it?
Yep, I got it.
Alright. Okay then, I guess we can go now. I'm so glad we're finally here. I kept thinking I might die. Sorry for making you girls sick. You're a tough one, Yukari.
Probably.
Probably? No probably about it. It's a definitely. Alright. That's the only moment. What else is different? Play cards. Gotcha. Okay, so until then. Next time I cut back, it'll be during the card sequence, so until then. Alright, card time. Yukari, let's go. I'll play along with Yukari. I think she's more worth than any of us for a victory. That sentence kind of makes sense. Subtly, I hinted at the card in my hand that she needed to take. After she took it and saw her fortunes change, she offers a warm smile.
It seems that I won.
Yukari scored just the right amount of points to win. Thrilled, she danced in celebration while Anko frowned in disappointment.
I almost won! Okay, time for revenge. Let's play another round.
Actually, I'm out.
Anna also had a very good combination, and could have won if she's managed to take a good card from Haruka.
Okay, I admit it. I have no idea what I'm doing. Maybe I won by accident.
Well, you didn't win, but you have a good combination. Haruka lowered her arms and went quiet, starting to get nervous.
Well, what about you? Show us your hand.
The combination in my hand is the weakest. I have no chance. Maybe we should just do something else
no,
now.
Reveal it now!
I slowly revealed my cards.
That's a pity.
What are we playing now? Who has the worst hand?
Haruka stuck to Anna, who seemed less than thrilled at the embrace, but didn't look like she had the strength to resist.
Don't worry. The only loser here is... and he'll be punished later.
Oh, you should feel sorry for him. He's so cute. I hope he survives.
What? Punishment? Why? I didn't agree to this.
Don't pity him, Haruka. Losers always deserved punishment.
Yukari stays silent.
Get ready. And don't you dare run away. Someone, keep an eye on him so he doesn't run.
Why do we have to watch this pervert? Do it yourself.
Well, Anna's gone already.
Ugh, she pisses me off so much.
You know, if you'd rather not watch me, I can just catch a nap in your room.
I don't think so.
Anko leaves and Haruka, visually upset, walks after her. She looks at me with sympathy as she does, and then runs down the hall. This is so much crap. I shouldn't have to be punished. What is everyone thinking around here? Frustrated and upset, I stay in the room alone with Yukari.
Thanks.
For what?
For the game. I'll definitely be writing it down in my diary.
Oh, hell yeah. Well, I just don't write down that I lost. I have to stay cool in your memories.
Yeah, okay. Deal.
After that, everyone just seemed to forget about my punishment. Apparently it was all a joke. I spent way too much time believing in. I'm gonna get you, Anna. Then we go through this.
What the?
What the hell? Yep. Yep, spep.
But
I get slapped.
What are you? Oh yeah.
Or he's if
fine.
Yeah. Then
I vote.
I.
Me too.
Okay, Yukari's the investigator. It's frustrating to me. I have no ba ba ba. Skilled me, maybe ba ba. Turning to leave, I hear footsteps. You hid them. Oh really? Crap.
Awesome.
Well, those are dangerous. This is just too painful to watch. I didn't steal any of those paintings. I need to say everything straight with the investigator if she'll even listen to me. Yukari sat quietly and calmly by the bright window, reading her diary. Yukari, I know who the thief
what
is.
What do you mean?
I mean, I figured it out. But it's not just one person.
What are you talking about? Are they dangerous?
Yukari seemed very surprised, not seeming to understand anything. Have you forgotten your job already? She lowered her head and nodded, slowly in embarrassment.
Yes. I forgot to write it down and I think I got carried away.
Oh, you're a dumbass. I hadn't realized. You said you were ready to investigate this case and walked all loud and proud.
Really?
That was like 5 minutes ago.
Sometimes.
After a moment, a sweet smile turned up the corners of her mouth.
Well, if someone stole our panties, I'd better get on it then.
Yes, but I already know who. Anna and Haruka were hiding them under a bush.
On the street? Does Anko know about this?
No, I didn't see her and needed to tell you immediately.
Then let's hurry up and get them.
Grabbing diary and pencil, Yukari jumped up and ran out of the room. Wait, wrong way. The street is to the right. Silently, she turned and made a mad dash to the exit. I showed her the bush and we sat down to examine the suspicious location.
Hey, Kari. What are the both of you doing?
Oh, us? It's nothing.
Getting up, she went over to her sister, leaving her diary open on the ground. I felt terrible, but my curiosity was just too intense. I snuck a look. Beautiful, elegant handwriting was matched with adorable sketches. These hot springs are the most beautiful I've ever visited. Nothing even comes close. I know my illness makes me want to remember everything, but even if I wasn't, I don't think I'd be able to forget about my time here with Anko, Haruka, Anna, and Kenji. Oh, she actually has like a real problem. Okay, I deeply apologize for calling her a dumbass then. She actually has like a legitimate illness, okay? We had such a wonderful time, and it was almost enough to make me forget I even have any problem. I was a part of everything, and they were so kind to be so patient. Kenji was especially wonderful to me. Always be grateful to us for inviting us all to be together. I'll try to remember this for the rest of my life. No, I will remember it. I will. I have to promise myself. We still have more time left to make incredible memories. I'm going to make the most of every moment. You're right, Yukari. Memories are everything. Make as many as you can. Oh no. She wrote I vomited in the car. That's not a necessary one to remember.
Sorry. Anko said she didn't find anything and hasn't seen Anna or Haruka.
Apparently, they're still up to something. Yukari picked up her diary and brushed off some dirt before making a note. What did you write? Can I see it?
No.
No.
Maybe one day. But I'm not ready to share. Anyway.
It looks like we have all the evidence we need. Time to go.
We didn't get any evidence, though. It was a great moment for Yukari. She rocked from side to side and scolded the guilty ones in a sweet little voice. That was nice, but also stern. After the verdict, she made Anna and Hanako wear the panties on their heads for an hour. Turns out, Yukari is quite a cruel judge. I don't ever want to be on her bad side. While everyone was busy laughing, I noticed Yukari had left her diary open again on the small table next to me. Once again, I couldn't help myself. But he peeked in my diary anyway. Okay, that's... I like that. Okay. So now we got one more ending left, and that's Anna's. So that's all I got left is just to cut right to the card game. Alright, so until then. Fuck! Alright, and we are back at the card game. One last person to play along with, and it's Anna. Anna clearly knows what she's doing, but what happens if I play along? I gave her a hint, and to my surprise, she instantly answered me.
Are you playing along or trying to fool me?
No way! Is it true?
Of course not, she's imagining things.
Okay, that's enough. Don't look at Anna, only at me.
And don't look at me!
Anna was unwavering. While I tried to understand Anna's intentions, I realized my combination failed, and I was suddenly losing. Hanako took a card I needed. Staring at my cards, I tried to look for a way out of my losing situation. Suddenly, I felt a poke from Anna's side. Had she decided to help? Or not? I can't be certain, but I have nothing to lose. I took the card she pointed at. Sure enough, it's exactly the card I needed. I can win! Anna winked at me, and my heart slammed in my chest. Anna winked at me? But after a moment, she again became arrogant. Became an arrogant snow queen, and leaves me to wonder if I didn't just imagine the whole thing. Hey girls, seems like
I win!
My ears popped from Anka's excited scream.
I won! Finally, I won! Look!
Revealing her cards, she showed they were stronger than mine, and the rest.
Couldn't win even like that.
Clearly she was talking
Congrats,
to me.
Anko? Congrats. I also wanted to win.
Ha! You can't surpass me!
You won for the first time since we started.
So what? You won for the first time but act like a baby swimming in candy. Calm down.
Anna! I'm just trying to have fun!
Yeah, and so is she. Anna finally showed some joy that lay in stark contrast against the cold, unfeeling girl with the unmelted heart. And in their own joy, everyone began to laugh, even Anko, and me. Okay, and how does this change the whole panties got stolen thing? Yep, Anko comes in, she's all pissed. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. Now we're in the closet. Okay. Headed outside. Will they hide the panties there? I quite leave the building and hide behind a bush. Still, I notice on his hands. Yep.
Wow, you're really good. How do you know the perfect place to hide panties?
Well, you could say I've had some previous experience.
What kind of experience?
I'm just teasing you.
Oh. Well, what happens now?
Well, we should.
Anna glimpsed the top of my head peeking from out of the bushes.
We should get out of here since no one's noticed us.
After that, I quickly ran back into the building, but had no idea as to my next move. I still didn't have an alibi, and I could only hope a miracle happened. I could only hope a miracle happened. During the trial, I was the main suspect in a really bad position. Each girl testified to her version of events and my character during the trip. The story sounded good against me, as if they'd all conspired to blame me.
So, what do you have to say for yourself?
Wait.
Queen Anna took center stage.
Yes, he might be a pervert, but he has an alibi. I saw him reading his porn magazines in his room.
Oh, fuck. That's great.
The truth is, I did it. I stole the panties.
Why? Why would you do that?
Haruka walked over and whispered to Anna.
Why? Did you tell them? I thought we had a plan.
A plan?
Yes. It was our plan all along to play a prank on this pervert here.
Which we should have played until the very end. It would have been funny.
Yeah, but it would be better to confess.
Anna, always ruining my fun.
Haruka jumped on Anna and hugged her tightly as everyone laughed. Okay. Is that it? Okay, no, there's more.
Why did you come out here too?
I thought you might want to talk.
Wow, you think pretty highly of yourself. But to be honest, I kinda do want to talk. I owe you that much. I've never done anything like that before. And I guess I got caught up in it.
Like when you'd steal your friend's panties?
No, it's different. God, you were just disgusting. It was like a team game. We teamed up with Haruka not in order to make others feel bad, but to make people happy. To prank all of you and laugh together.
Well, I'm happy you got to have your fun. But tell me, what made you end it so early? I could have suffered much longer.
I kind of felt sorry for you even though you don't deserve it. I had my fun and I just figured it was better to stop. It kind of changed me. I should have agreed to this trip much earlier. I had a good time.
Hell yeah.
If I'd missed out on all this fun, I'd have never forgiven myself. Gosh, I'm so stubborn sometimes.
Yes. The cold, stubborn queen of panty thieving. Anna stared at me for a moment before she erupted in laughter.
Thank you. Thanks to all of you, I'm closer to showing my true self.
Do it. Do it. Hell yeah. Hell yeah, okay, I don't care about this shit. Get out of my face. So we have one last ending. The fortunate man ending. Where you don't fucking show any favoritism towards any of them. I don't know how this ends, but it says fortunate man, so maybe that's a good thing. Who knows? But one more ending. So, until then. Oh, shit. Okay. So, going down the fortunate man route, in which I haven't showed any favoritism towards any of them. And now, as we're hiding in the closet, Anna says, wait, I think someone might be in the closet. Go on.
Oh, I doubt that.
No, we have to check it out.
Oh, great. This is the end of me. Even as I hoped it wouldn't, the closet door swung open.
Well, well. What do we have here?
Oh, no way! How could you?
Sorry, I got confused and slipped into the wrong room.
And what's under here? Stolen panties.
Yes, stolen by you two.
What happened in here?
Yukari entered the room after the racket.
Look at it yourself.
No, it's not what it looks like. I'm in the wrong room and they stole these.
Be quiet. You're in a closet with all the stolen panties. I don't think they need to know anything else.
Yeah, but he's such a cute pervert.
Gosh, this is so terribly unfair. Go on. Where does this... It just ends right there. At least while I was in the girls' closet, I was able to enjoy seeing all the girls' beautiful, sexy, and adorable panties at once. That's it? My god, that's the lamest route of them all. Okay, well, there you have it, folks. Yeah, I kind of just breezed through this game. I mean, I realized early on I wasn't going to enjoy it. I realized very early on that I was not going to have a whole lot of fun with this game. I don't know what the fuck I expected from it. It wasn't this, though. This was big yikes. Like, I did not an enjoyable experience. That's all I really have to say about it, you know? Like, honestly, what I don't understand is, like, how the fuck are you supposed to figure this shit out without a guide? Like, that last route, no, that's classic visual novel shit. Where it's like, oh, you fucking pick based on which girl you want, which thing you think is gonna impress which girl. That makes sense. That's classic visual novel shit. That last route 100 was 100% visual novel shit. There was no fucking, oh, find the items, fucking manipulate the items, find the underwear, blah, 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 blah. Like, I knew that was an aspect of this game, but, like, I didn't realize that was the primary focus. I didn't realize these chapters would be, like, I don't know, like, fucking, what, 10 minutes? 10, 15 minutes for a chapter? This was a very disappointing experience. I expected it to be a much longer game. It wasn't. I expected there to be a bit more to it. Like, I knew it wasn't going to be a serious game that was going to get me, like, you know, sucked in emotionally or anything, but, like, I definitely expected more than what I got. And those endings were just awful. There's, like, no real sense of closure to any of them. Yukari's probably came the closest to probably being, like, the best ending. Yukari's or Anna's. Those were semi-decent endings. I'd give those endings, like, 7 out of 10. They were all right. You know, Anna's ending gets 8 out of 10. Yukari's gets 7. The other three... bad. Real bad. But, gonna end this one here. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I didn't. And I will see you in the next episode of whatever the hell it is I make. Make, play. I don't make games, I play them. I play Vidya. Anyway, until then, peace. What's up, guys? Editing IPlayVidya from the future here. Just popping in to say, I know some of you may have noticed in the chapter selection that there was a selection titled Epilogue that I did not do. I totally forgot it was there, accidentally skipped over it, and now knowing it is there, I don't have the motivation to play it. I don't want to. I just, plain and simple, I don't want to. I don't want to waste any more time on this game. It's not fun. I don't care what the epilogue may or may not have to offer. It's just not worth it. It isn't. So for anyone thinking, like, oh, he must have forgot I was there, you know, we should let him know. Maybe he'll do it. No need. I'm purposely choosing not to do it, but I do know it's there. Sorry if that fucking bothers anyone who wanted me to fucking see it through to the complete end. I've seen enough. But anyway, just want to pop in, say that, clear that up. So now that that's out of the way, here comes the end screen.